challenges for the future.
Question is, will they kill untold millions as they did in the last century? It is not the elite cockroaches that determine that. It is you.
The average man and woman is in a trance. They get home from work. They don't even talk to their children. They turn the television on. And they let those corporate messages set the agenda in their lives.
All you ever hear about in this country is our differences. That's all the media and the politicians are ever talking about, the things that separate us, things that make us different from one another. That's the way the ruling class operates in any society. They try to divide the rest of the people. They keep the lower and the middle classes fighting with each other so that they, the rich, can run off with all the fucking money. Fairly simple thing happens to work. You know, anything different, that's what they're going to talk about. Race, religion, ethnic and national background, jobs, income, education, social status, sexuality, anything they can do, keep us fighting with each other so that they can keep going to the bank.
Divide and conquer is the motto. And as long as people continue to see themselves as separate from everything else, they lend themselves to being completely enslaved.
We've all seen vast herds or flocks of sheep controlled by a sheepdog and an authority figure called a shepherd. You imagine if just a significant number, not even half, of those sheep said, we're not going to succumb to fear of the sheepdog, and we are going to go our own way. And those sheep start going in their own way, they start expressing their uniqueness, and they stop acquiescing with the authority figure and succumbing to fear. Where's the power of the shepherd now? Where's the power of the sheepdog now? They have no power except in acquiescence by the mass of the sheep to the perceived power that they have. We need to start seeing humanity in these terms very, very quickly.
I don't intend to, I mean, I'm not trying to offend anyone, but I'm just trying to tell you where religions come from. Religions have been given to us by the same people who gave us our government, our banks, our educational institutions, our whole entire ruddy system in Western civilization is based on religion, politics, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. It's just business. It's just money. It's just the control of people.
Think for yourself. Question authority. Think for yourself. Question authority. Throughout human history, as our species has faced the frightening, terrorizing fact that we do not know who we are or where we're going in this ocean of chaos, it has been the authorities, the political, the religious, the educational authorities who attempted to comfort us by giving us order, rules, regulations, forming in our minds their view of reality. To think for yourself, you must question authority and learn.
Gentlemen, you are not the weak-kneed, sissy morons they try to portray us on television either. You are strong, you are family-oriented, you have faith, and you are warriors. And you're going to need to take a stand and defend your country and your family. But we need to make some changes. We need to create the space for us to be free enough to explore those possibilities. We cannot do that with the power structure that's in existence today. So we need to create another domain of knowing. So it's very simple steps. And again, it individually, this doesn't necessarily, I mean, this has to be a grassroots. And all it takes is a focus, a turn of our focus away from the drama and the crap that they want us to focus on the news and CNN, etc., and start thinking about, what is it that I want? What information do I want to know? What do I want to hear? What information do I want to hear on the news? What kind of neighborhood do I want to live in? Okay, what do I want to talk to my friends about? What's really important to me? And ladies and gentlemen, back in 1993, I was telling everybody to throw their televisions away. I really was.
Guilty. I wouldn't do anything that I felt guilty about.
You don't feel guilty at all?
There's no need to feel guilty. I haven't done anything I'm ashamed of. Maybe I haven't done enough. I might be ashamed of that, for not doing enough, for not giving enough, for not being more perceptive, for not being aware enough, for not understanding, for being stupid.
We need to step into our power here. We need to fully understand it's time for us to step into our power as a planetary race and not see the borders anymore. Now, I would not be that opposed to a global government if it was set up with a constitution like the U.S. Constitution and an absolute Bill of Rights. But even then, that's not a guarantee, because if people don't defend those rights, if people don't defend their liberties, what good is it?